We're off to continue our journey east. Businessmen fly because it cuts their travel time more than half. The time they save getting there, they use being there. They can't afford not to travel by air. Out of Detroit, now over Canada, the natural flying route between Chicago and New York. Welland Canal, its locks are arranged for vessels 800 feet in length. This drawing illustrates the radio impulses which help the pilot keep his course. This radio range beacon guides the pilot as accurately as steel rails define the course for cracked trains. Buffalo, but an hour and a half from Detroit. Niagara, thunder of waters. Oh, the majestic bridal veil of nature. 15 million cubic feet of water every minute, falling in a cataract of splendor. You'll see it on the American Airways route, the scenic way to fly. Buffalo Airport. This is one of the principal crossroads of the Chicago-New York line, as well as the Boston-Cleveland line, an important passenger, mail, and express transfer point. Here we meet two sections of a westbound New York-Chicago schedule. The other two planes you see are leaving for Boston and Cleveland. As you look out of the plane, each passing mile reveals new scenes. Nature painting canvases of rare beauty on the earth below, a checkerboard pattern of miniature homes. At the foot of the Blue Ridge Mountains, the natural trade route of earlier America, you're near historic Delaware Water Gap. In the pioneer days, an Indian trail wound along the base of the mountain. Enjoyable, educational, scenic. That's why more people each year make flying a habit. And that is one of the reasons for the tremendous increase in the traffic of American Airways, a romance of modern business. At night, the skyway is lighted by Department of Commerce beacons every 10 or 15 miles. Compare this lighthouse beacon of only 360,000 candle power, visibility 17 to 25 miles, with this Airways beacon of 2 million candle power, visibility 50 to 100 miles. Truly, the skyway is the bright way. It's twilight in the heavens. The journey's end is near. New York, the teeming city of millions, the melting pot of the nation. A warm glow in the plane lights it up like a fairy ship in the night. If it's a bit cool, the stewardess will turn the heat on. If it's too warm, she'll open up the ventilators to let in the cool, fresh air that's clean above the dirt and soot and smoke of the earth below. Come on, old-timer, you've had your share. There's a difference in travel time from Chicago to New York if you go by plane. If your time has value, you increase your worth several-fold whenever you travel by air. Newark, eastern terminal of the Chicago-New York trip. Think of it. You can have lunch in Chicago and dinner in New York on the same day.
It's not a boy. It's twins.
Now you can spend the evening in New York for recreation, Broadway's bright lights, your favorite eating place, the theater. And then to bed in a first-class hotel. A good night's sleep that will prepare you for the busy day ahead. Another traveler delivered to his appointed destination. Adding to the mounting totals of American Airways achievements, over 330,000 passengers carried safely in 7 years, over 50 million air miles, nearly 2,000 times around the world. Fly American.